Hi, I've prepared for you a little teaser on the capabilities of the Cassady software framework. If you have a look at our recent journal publication and look at the title, it's a nice description. It says a software framework for nonlinear optimization and optimal control. And it has very wide applications in literature. For example, there are people doing prediction of icebergs with it. It's used for bioreactor modeling and control. It's used for thermal control of buildings. There's even a company that uses it commercially. And it's used also in wind energy. Just a few applications. So what is the overall picture? Cassady gives you a set of mathematical blocks that you can conveniently compose. You compose them into either you can use them to solve your large or complex applications, or you can build other software tools on top. And both things are done with people in literature. We work often with dynamic optimization, so we need some kind of model. So it's differential equations or differential algebraic equations. You can model them in Python or MATLAB with a nice symbolic language, or you can import them from Modelica or from example Simscape. Types of problems we can solve, or people use Cassady to solve, is nonlinear programming in general, and then in particular direct methods for optimal control. So they give rise to large NLP problems. What can you do with optimal control? You could do MPC, model predictive control, or you can do iterative learning control, ILC. Just a few to give an idea. Then some ideas about tools that are built by some people. For example, ACADOS from the Freiburg University Group for MPC. You have MPC tools from the group of Jim Rawlings. And you have RTC tools, which is a product from the Netherlands that deals with waterways. So what is at Cassady's core? There are expression graphs. Any engineering computation you want to do, you should in the end express as an algorithm. And the algorithm is represented in memory as a graph. Like here on the left, you have a vector of length 5, and we're taking the 2 norm of it. So y is a computation that depends on the input x. We can ask to Cassady to just give us the gradient, the Jacobian or the Hessian, or in fact any order of differentiation from an output expression to some input expression. So in this case, you would get a division node inserted. So in fact, these graphs, we have two types of them. We have scalar graphs, which are very fast, and we also have graphs with nodes that are matrices, and these scale very well for large applications. So you have here a set of mathematical operations that you can compose. All the operations here, they can be differentiated algorithmically, can be exported to standalone C code. You can do multi-threading with them, and recently also multi-processing. So this would mean sending it to a cluster to do massive parallelization. So that's the mathematical primitives. Then you have around it, let's say, are some more standard mathematical problem formulations like nonlinear programming and NLP. We have also a block to do integration of dynamic systems. We have a block for root finding. We have a block for solving linear systems and for QPs and in general convex programming. And then we have on the other edge third-party packages that we interface. These are the plugins. So the first is the IPOPT plugin. So IPOPT is very well at solving large-scale nonlinear optimal, large-scale nonlinear programming. We have also an interface to the Bonmin package, so you could do mixed integer problems. And there are several others, SQP type methods, and so on. In terms of integration, we can use the adaptive step size solver from Sundials, or we have our own collocation or Runge-Kutta algorithms. Then we have the root finding. It speaks for itself. For linear solve, we have an interface to MA27 from HSL, and a LAPACK and C-sparse for sparse matrix inversion. In terms of the QPs, we have the classic ones like the Cplex package and the Gurobi. And we have a couple of ones that are dedicated to model predictive control. So HPMPC is really exploiting the block structure of an optimal control transcription. And we have QP Oasis, which is from the Freiburg group, or actually the Leuven group initially. And then we have QRQP, which is a solver that the main author of Cassady, Joel Anderson, wrote recently. It's also an active set method. And then there are other additions, like we can do lookup tables with an interpolant block. We can use linear interpolation or spline interpolation. And we can also have custom blocks. So in the past, I've did things like offloading computations to the GPU with a custom block, making connection with TensorFlow. You can find it on the Cassady blog. And also make connection with other AD tools like ADLC. So a lot of things are possible. So you express your algorithm as mathematical operations, and you can differentiate them all the way. So here, let's go to a single shooting optimal control problem. Very simple. So we start out with decision variables. We have a vector u of length 4, which is like the control inputs to steer a dynamical system. So f represents the time discretization of a dynamical system with two states. We have an initial state, 0, 1, and using the control input, the first control input, we can propagate it to the next time step. Then we have state at time t equals 1. We give it as input to another state propagation block, and so on. Now, in the end, we have an expression that depends on the inputs and has these state propagation blocks included. And inside this block, you could put an integrator, like the Sun-Niles adaptive integrator. And we can still ask for the derivative of this guy with respect to the inputs, and it would differentiate right through the integration blocks. So that's how you can compose large-scale optimization problems. So in terms of syntax, how would it look like? We start with declaring the variable for the controls. So it's a vector of n by 1, with n is equals 4 in this case. Then we have a simple for loop to code all these guys at once. So we start out with the state 0, 1, and then update x as we go along forward in time. Then in the end, what do we want to do? Maybe we want to minimize the overall effort, the control effort. So I just put the objective to this guy, and then we constrain to the state at the end to be 0. So we're looking for the control signal that brings all states to 0 with minimal effort. Simple optimal control. We choose a solver like IPOPT. We solve the actual problem. And now we can query the solution for the numerical value of these optimization variables. And we would get a graph like this. So we have 4 control inputs. They are given in red. And we have the states that start from 1, 0, and in 4 time steps collapse to 0 as we required. So that's single shooting. And to show you how powerful Cassady is, we can go from this formulation to multiple shooting very easily. The only thing we need to do is add extra variables for the states. So we're going to do that. We're going to make extra variables. We have 2 states, and we repeat it n plus 1 times. Now, to put the beginning constraint, we just set the first entry, the first column of x, to 0, 1. And then we have the system propagation, which is now put as a constraint. So it's a gap closing constraint. So what we're saying is the state propagation of x and u should be there's a k missing here. Yeah. So the state at x, the state at time k, and the control at time k together propagates to a new state, and this should equate the state, the decision variable at k plus 1. The objective stays the same, and the constraints now relate to not just X, but only the last column of it. And you would get the exact same picture as you get here, but it has different numerical properties. It solves faster. Okay, so this is a recipe for multiple shooting. We can do further introspection. We could, for example, ask for what is the Jacobian of all constraints with respect to all decision variables. That you could do with a simple line like this, and you could plot it in a picture like here. So here on the vertical axis we have all constraints, and on the horizontal axis we have here the control variables and here the state variables. And as you see, Cassady automatically does the derivation and also exploits the sparsity of the structure. Right. So in summary, with Cassady you can easily do nonlinear optimization and optimal control. The source code is on GitHub as an LGPL license. You can use it commercially if you want. It's multilingual. You can use it in C++, in MATLAB, or in Python. If you want to know more, visit our website, or you can also subscribe for a workshop that is upcoming. Thank you for your attention.